Welcome back, dear watercolor people. I hope you enjoyed yesterday's demo. You may remember I did painted my motif, but now it has dried for almost 24 hours, which means, depending on the paper, that we can paint over it again with another layer without destructing the underpainting too much. So I will start with a little bit of genuine rose for the roof. And I should take my glasses on. I can see my painting much better then. So I don't want it to be completely color, but at least it should be a little bit more colorful. So this is a pretty easy way to suggest that that roof isn't new. Because I always think about how can I tell my story with a brush. Of course you could paint this roof pretty detailed and show every detail, but I prefer this way. Just thinking about what kind of brush strokes could simulate something old. I think I take off this genuine rose here. And maybe there should just be a little bit here in the reflection too. Okay. So now I mix a little bit of this is cadmium yellow and cobalt orange. And you see, we can paint. If we don't press the brushes too much, we can paint a layer over the previous painting. And when this is dry, it looks pretty nice because we have a much bigger range of different color shades there. Maybe a little bit here, but not too much. And of course, for the reason of balance, it should be here a little bit too. shows a little bit of one of my favorite paints. It's this Cobalt Turquoise. I think I just simulate a little bit of reflection of the trees here. It's a little bit too much. So now it's Caput Mortem to add a few darker details here. I think I mix it with some, this is my indigo. Yeah, now it is. So sometimes I come to the point when I think, when I suddenly think a painting has been overdone. But in this case, it looks pretty good still. And I can really show you how I develop my pictures. Now we need some more darkness here. We can also use a smaller flat brush. So you see, I create my brush strokes as far as possible in a big variety. Because in nature, the varieties are unlimited. And so I just try to translate this into my brush language. This is a paint almost from the tube. And so it's almost opaque. So it's sitting pretty nice on the paint. So some more serum blue here to add more to the darker side. Maybe some hectic think this looks better when it's not too clean. Try to add a little bit of light ochre here. Pretty dry. I never know when I come back to a painting if it's still the same fun like I had before with it, but this time I can tell you, yeah, I still love to paint in this picture, and this is for me the most important thing, and I think the result will be pretty good, at least see it this way. So these sprinkles help me to bring in more interesting here in the dark, because I want everything in this picture to be pretty lively, suggesting a summer storm, because of course I was, or I am, a little bit inspired by the weather we have here today and yesterday. Rain, thunder, lightning, storm, and it's still pretty humid here. Makes it everything a little bit more strenuous than usual, but it's okay. White to my cadmium turquoise to make it a little bit brighter. It's So this adds another nice accent to my painting, but you shouldn't overdo it with this. This is opaque white. Maybe you have realized that I put a timeless video from this top camera from yesterday's painting again. The full demo is available on my YouTube channel. Just look for Carsten Wieland watercolors. I almost forgot, because it's the last day of my celebration for Lucas Paints. I decided to give you a few, exactly three ebook packages with my best tutorials. I think you find it on the post below. The only thing you have to do is just subscribe to my YouTube channel and then send me an email with your YouTube username. Right, I want the ebooks. And this way, three of you can get a package with four different watercolor tutorial books, including my bestsellers. So I thought I would put this beside and start another painting parallel, but I had so much fun. You should always paint as long as there's something like a thrill. So now I'm going to suggest the windows here at the dark side. Let me look at the reference, too detailed. Just a few brush strokes with this smaller flat brush. So maybe you can realize that I paint my other watercolors the same way as I learned it with my loose florets. So this really is a great training. And I recommend it. Here. So far, I think it's okay. Now it has to dry a little bit again. So if you want to take a look. And I put it beside now for a little bit. And I promise you to start another one. I have some paper down here. And I decided for a little seascape with the shipwreck or something like that. Really spontaneous. And most important for me in this is the motion of the sea. I start with this Chinese brush and the Lucas Turquoise. So this will be one of my waves. Now some cyan blue. So you can see I try to paint this full of expression from the brush. I guess you can't paint like that when you sit in front of your watercolor. This is why I always recommend try painting standing in front of your watercolor. Flat brush. I do pretty much the same. Here comes some Prussian green. you see, I still paint in the same directions like I did to you. Now I want some more greenish here on the so I think this will be the space where my shipwreck is there. Some opaque white. And there are some pretty wet parts now, and a few where I paint a little bit less watery, more dry, and then the paper structure works for me here too. Okay, now I want some rocks here. They should have a deep contrast to the sea. I start with orange. And now the rocks. Have a little bit different direction from the strokes. Some English red. For the main shapes, just one brush stroke for segment. Only this way I can really use my brush is the best way. This is cut with autumn again, and I think I'm bringing some ultramarine here too. Ooh, it's still pretty hot inside here, and with the lights on, it's even more. drama to the sea. There's some Prussian green and indigo. And I think use this dark blue too. Will be the sky. I think there will be a rest of sunlight here. And so I use some this was light ochre. Okay. And for the wind, I would like to have this direction. So now comes indigo. Dry the brush a little bit. This way I can take all a little bit of paint here and bring it more into each other. Thank you. Now I'll take the paper off and this way the colors melt a little bit better into each other. And now I'm going to put this aside and come back to my other painting to finish it. Yeah, this has dried a little bit and I now can put in the last details. I think I use a little bit of opaque white and with some other paint color for the windows here in the front of the building. Just simulating details again. And do something similar here. I'm saying okay all the time today. Maybe just because I feel okay. I hope you do too. So almost finished, but now of course here has to be this detail from the old mill. This is indigo again. Just to add a few darks. So I think it's almost finished now. Just adding a few lines here. So this is something which is pretty hard to explain, because when you paint, you always have to decide yourself when you like to finish your painting. But in most cases I just paint as long as I have fun with it and think there could be more structure or another detail. But now I really think I should You see, it's not that easy to finish all the time. So the easiest way to finish your watercolor is to take some Lucas Red on your brush and sign your painting. Then it's done. Let me see if I can turn it to you already. So this is it so far. You see there's some paint still running. So I take this off a little bit. Yeah. And put it aside and come back to my other painting again. So this is not completely dry, but I think I can start to paint in the shipwreck I was talking about. So this is English Red and a small flat brush. First of all, try to bring in the, how was it called, the corpus of the ship, or, sorry, my English isn't, it's a little bit rusty. Lucas Red too. reality. Yeah. Later today, I will post my last short tutorial for this celebration time. And this is then a painting which is similar to this one. And of course, there will be the tabletop camera on YouTube tomorrow. So now I think I try to bring in a little bit of reflection from the ship here. Not too much. With my fingers sometimes. Saying this, okay. I don't know. So now the most detailed parts. Sorry, I have to concentrate here a little bit because I don't want to mess it up. And painting expressive and talking at the same time is pretty strenuous. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to write me an email or contact me on my social media accounts. If you have any question about painting with watercolors or would like to show me your paintings to be reviewed or whatever, just get in contact with me. I will always try to respond and help you as quick as possible. think I take a smaller brush for these details. They are not really details again, they are just a few lines to simulate details. So maybe you ask yourself, how is it possible to paint a ship without reference? But of course I have sketched a lot of ships before. And now with this training I'm just able to paint a ship. It's not realistic, of course not. But I think you just realize it's a ship. And this is what for me is more important than all the details. The only problem that I have with it, that it should more turn to the side and shook by the wind. I don't know, I forgot about this. To suggest the mast of another ship that has been going down already. To finish it, I will put a few details on the rocks. Now I'm using the paint. pretty thick. Not really watery, because I just want to add an impression of a rock, a rocky coast. I think it's brush. It's hitting its last days because this is pretty loose here. More darkness up here. So and this will be indigo again. So I always look where can I put in some drama to my painting. What's that? There was something on the brush, I think, from this. Sing a little bit. So now just adding a few sprinkles of opaque white and mixed with the keys. Usually this doesn't happen, but this is because it's so hot and humid today. So the paper sticks on my finger pretty quick. I think I leave it this way. Maybe it doesn't matter too much. Probably running a little bit now, but it doesn't. So this is how it looks so far. I will post, of course, a picture of it. And the painting video from the top will be available tomorrow. The complete demo on my YouTube channel and the time-lapse version then here on Lucas and my Instagram accounts. Yeah, I really enjoyed this week of watercolor painting. To celebrate Lucas Paints' 160th anniversary. I hope you did enjoy it too. Like I said, whenever you like to contact me with questions about watercolor painting, workshops, or just what kind of brushes I would recommend, then just contact me with an email to wieland.fineart@gmail.com, and I would be really happy if you subscribe my YouTube channel. There are more than 300 watercolor videos online already, and I'm posting you every week. And it's just more fun when you do this for a bigger community. And don't forget to, when you subscribe, to write me an email if you want to win one of the free ebook sets. There will be a new book from me in September. I'm working on it since half a year. I'm pretty sure this will be the best watercolor book that I've done, because it puts everything I teach in my live workshops into a book, and even more. And I think you can be busy with these step-by-step workshops for weeks or months, depending on how much you like to paint. And the last tip, as always, is keep on painting, even if you have the feeling that you fail, just put the one thing you don't like by side, start another one, but keep your brushes moving. Because you can only learn painting by painting. It's not enough when you put your tutorial books under your pillow at night. No, you have to paint. So I arranged my whole life to be able to paint almost every day. It's probably not necessary if you are not that enthusiastic, but try at least to paint one or two times a week, because if you don't do this, it will be hard to get the feeling of making progress. Thank you so much, my dear friends. I hope you enjoyed, and please join the other artists here on this channel from Lucas Paints. I really enjoyed this week, and I would like to thank Lucas Paints again for their support and for our friendship since 2016, and happy anniversary again. Thank you so much. Bye bye. Happy painting.